Hello everybody, let's do a little workout for the abdominal muscles with the hypopressive method. So what are you going to do? I know you're going to say, what is hypopressive? Hypo means low pressure, low pressure means pressure, low pressure. Why? Because when you are having an abdomen that is like this, and you have done any type of workout and the abdomen doesn't go away, what is the problem there? An excess of pressure in the abdominal cavity. So what we have to do, sit-ups, sit-ups, the sit-ups produce more excess of pressure in the abdominal cavity. And also the worst of that, so much pressure makes the pelvic floor muscles weaker. And what happened? You know, problems like urinary incontinence when you are lifting or when you are carrying something heavy. So pay attention with what exercise are you choosing to do to make your abdominal muscles stronger. So I'm going to teach you the hypopressive here. So the hypopressive is not just about the breathing, it's about the posture. The most important is your posture. Why? Because you want to activate the right muscles. If you do hypopressive, you're going to improve your posture. You're going to be in a very good alignment. It's going to help you to be more aware of having a right posture at all times. So just pay attention how I make changes in my posture, okay? Like this. Shoulders like this, no, down. Okay, hands, how the hands go. Okay, and then you rotate. Why? Because when you rotate the hands, you help the ribcage to open. The diaphragm, there's a muscle that goes all in this position to the middle back, is going to be able to stretch and give more room to the organs to go up. Okay, ready? Let's do this. Alignment, very important. So, feet align with my hips, okay? So let's start simple. Bring the shoulders down and just do this movement. When you do that, just feel your body and feel how when you go forward, your pelvic floor muscles will contract. Go forward, go back. If your shoulders feel up, bring it down. Make yourself taller. A good way to make sure that you have a right alignment is to rest your, your body against the wall. And here you just bring the shoulders back, push against the wall, make a double chin, and just hold it there. Here I can feel my core muscles pushing hard. That's a good way, and then when you stand that you feel in a better position. Okay, so let's keep using the wall, okay? So you bring those shoulders down, make a double chin. Put your hands at your hip level. Bring the shoulders back just for alignment. This is just alignment. Push that wall against your back. Good, and now let's work on the breathing. You know, when you do exercises, always do the one that feels right for me. After doing many exercises in the past, I realized that this is the one that worked for me. So I do this every morning. This is one of my secrets. And also, you know, the best part, help me with my digestion, you know. Take me straight to the bathroom. Yoga. Oh, and I'm a doctor of physical therapy, but also I'm a yoga instructor. So in yoga we do dhyana. I'm pretty sure for you guys it's easier to understand more about this breathing. But why I want to include yoga? Uddiyana, because Uddiyana, Bandha, you massage your organs. So it's different to hypopressive, because hypopressive focus in the posture, in the alignment. In Uddiyana Bandha, we focus on massaging the organ and the breathing. So you see the difference, right? And so let's do this. So this is the Uddiyana Bandha. So while you do, okay, you're going to lean forward because this activates the pelvic floor muscle. You inhale deep. Exhale. Hold your breath. Now, Uddiyana Bandha, that you was massaging my organs. Now, hypopressive is postural. It's all postural. Also, something very good that you can do during hypopressive is to have a ball in front of you, so you just lean forward. So, because remember, every time that you lean forward, you activate the pelvic floor muscles. Make sure when you do hypopressive, you always work on releasing all, you know, you finish the breathing and you do, and then make sure that you exhale deeper, because you don't want to accumulate too much acid in your blood. And then you're going to feel dizzy. That is why it's very good to exhale many times until you recover. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. This is the way that I keep my core stronger. It's this, even when I go to yoga classes, and all the time I combine the knowledge from Dr. Cafres, and I work in my posture, and at the same time I work on yoga with the Uddiyana Bandha. I mix this together and feel great in my body, in my mind, in my soul. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I